Hello friends, greetings. I am Dr. Gunashekaran, Principal, Dole Patil College of Physiotherapy. Very glad to meet you on this occasion of World Athletic Day 2021. Today we are going to understand the effect of mind preparation and training. Mostly we used to train our body, but this is a chance we are going to learn how effectively and efficiently that we are going to train your mind. Let's go to the presentation. Mental skills training. There is a saying, if you can believe it, your mind can achieve it. So here we are going to learn how effectively that we train our mind to control, regulate our body. Prevention is better than cure. But after this lecture, you'll be able to understand prevention and mind preparation is better than cure. Let's go to the topic of what is called about mind or mental skills training. Before we start today's presentation on mental skills training, I would want to brief you about effects of lockdown over athletes. What are risks active athletes supposed to face? First and foremost comes physical deconditioning. Whatever the health and functioning of all the organs, because of your good training earlier, now it is lack. You are not able to play. You are not able to do your training. That puts something called as physical deconditioning. And psychological health and well-being is a predominant functioning of your physical system. This lockdown creates lot of psychological parameters to play. Example, anxiety and depression, frustration, stress about your performance. All these psychological parameters will affect athletic performance. So how to overcome these psychological parameters such as anxiety, frustration, stress? We need to know the mental skills training or psychological skills training. Let us understand the definition of mental or psychological skills training. This is a set of cognitive somatic, that means mind and body approaches, addressing, targeting to improve the quality and capacity of a mind to overcome, to regulate, and to control the physical and psychological system of a person when he or she practices or when they do their competition. This is very unique program. Organized strategy consists of skills such as progressive relaxation techniques, mental imagery techniques, motivational self-talk, and goal setting, etc. Before we get into these skills training program, we need to understand what is mental toughness. Mental toughness is very simple to understand. It is an athlete's ability to cope with various psychophysiological demands of training and competition better than his opponent player, which is very clearly what is your capacity to handle your stressful environment, how much better one can handle her or his stress than his opponent player. Then that is what called as mental toughness. Relaxation strategy is the first and foremost important technique in mental skills training. Physical relaxation strategies can be done by progressive muscular relaxation techniques, mental relaxation can be done by centering and breathing technique. For progressive muscular relaxation technique, one need to lie down or sit on the chair with a backrest. Have to contract the muscles hard as possible, hold it for few seconds, then relax the muscle as much as you can. One can start the muscles of the feet, both the toes, all 10 toes can be tightly flexed or bent or grasped against the floor. Tighten it for 5 count and relax them as much as possible. Repeat the same for twice or thrice. Then you can move on to the knee muscles. Tighten your quadriceps, that is the thigh muscle, as much as possible. Hold the contraction for 5 seconds. Then gradually let it go. Relax your muscles maximum. Then you can come to the hip joint. Tighten the buttocks muscle as much as possible. Then hold it for a few seconds and relax it. Then go to the abdominal area. Tighten the abdominal muscles for some second, 5 to 10 seconds. Hold it very tight contraction, then relax. Then progressively with the chest muscles, then shoulder muscles, then neck muscles. So you can feel the contraction of the muscles are maximum. Once you allow the muscles to contract maximum, the muscle will go to maximum relaxation. That is what the benefit. Most of us, we are not relaxing the muscles fully. When you look at the problem, what athlete faces like back pain, neck pain, knee pain, all because of the muscles are not relaxing fully. There are constant contraction all the time present that initiates the cycle of tightness. So we need to understand how importance of this relaxation strategy is all about. The second thing comes to the mental relaxation. This is called a centering or breathing control strategy. You have to be calmly sitting on the chair. Close your eyes. Take a deep inhalation. Just follow your breathing. Your air enters to the nostrils. It enters to the windpipe. It enters to the lungs. You feel the lungs are expanding maximum. And you are expelling out by your lungs are collapsing. Your lungs are shrinking, coming back to its original size, and your air is coming out in the windpipe, your air is coming out through the nostrils. So this is what something where you really concentrate your breath, your own breath, your breathing pattern, that really works your mind to calm down. That is called as mental relaxation strategy. Mental imagery is very important mental skills training. One have to sit comfortably and think the situation in his mind as really the things happening or occurring. As it is shown in the picture, a runner have to think thus his starting position, his starting stance, and he is about to start to run. He is running as quick as possible. Sprinter will have to think about his exact experience of the way he starts the sprinting. That is how a very vivid mental experience, a clear internal picture of various activities during practice or competition can be brought into the mind. Later we train subject with game specific imagination. Boxer will have to train with a boxing technique. Sprinter will have to train with the sprinting technique. Footballers will have to train with various skills involved in the football game, agility and kicking performance and shooting performance and defending performance. All such performance can be mentally experienced, can be mentally put a very clear picture, is what called as mental imagery technique. Self-talk, talk to within, talk to yourself. One of the interesting mental skill. Everybody must do this when you train or during your competition. There are various times we get demotivated. We get stressed out. In those times, some kind of motivational self-talk. Example, good. Keep it up. Keep moving. Do it. You can do it. This kind of motivational, very short phrases, which suits for you, which you have to develop by your own understanding, can be utilized that particular time to guide you in the time of demotivation, in the time of stress, in the time of frustration. The second type of this is instructional self-talk. You are giving your instruction to your own self. Shoot exactly to the direction. Shoot. I can. You can easily do it. You are right. This kind of short phrases one can formulate by your own wish, by your own self. You have to practice during your training as well as during your competition time. Now the third is very important, that is positive self-talk. All the time we need to be positive. We can make these phrases easy, worth it, relax, cool. These kind of positive words can be practiced when you really in a stressful situation. So ultimately you have to select your own phrases out of your own wish and your own idea, and you have to use those the time of your demotivation, stress or frustration. Everyone must introduce their own phrases to use during the time of stress. I hope all of you understands about mental or psychological skills training. Any queries or any questions, please contact us. In future, we'll be coming with various interesting topics. Kindly share, kindly give us your maximum response. Thank you so much. God bless you.